Hi, welcome to this lighting talk. I am Lucas Benedicic. I am group lead for the infrastructure and development services at CSCS. And today I'm going to talk to you about a number of selected use cases for containers that we are working on at the Swiss National Supercomputing Center. I have selected two specific use cases to present to you today, namely the SCWASE2 European project and the Human Brain project, also funded by the European Union. So these use cases, they are enabled by different technologies. Specifically, the HPC aspect that is here represented by PeaceDyne, the hybrid Cray XC flagship system of CSCS, Docker containers on PeaceDyne deployed using Sarus, and the OpenStack platform that is deployed as an infrastructure as a service, using an infrastructure as a service model. Now, let me quickly go over SCWASE2. SCWASE2 stands for the Center of Excellence in Simulation and Climate in Europe. Its main focus is on resolving weather and climate simulation on pre and exascale supercomputers. Now, these simulations are backed by atmosphere and ocean models, which are mainly characterized by having complex dependencies, several external configurations, and very strict performance requirements. Specifically, containers on HPC can provide consistent environments for these models, thus improving their portability, easing the deployments, and maintaining the strict performance requirements that these models have. CSCS has been leading this effort in the context of the SCWASE2 project and has been helping scientists to create containers for their existing models. It is worth mentioning that most of these models have evolved, the software of these models have evolved through decades of research and development. So it is not easy to instantly containerize these softwares. The diagram on the screen shows the strong scaling performance of the Nemo code that was containerized by the Nemo team during a container hackathon that CSCS hosted during December 2019. As you can see, the blue boxes show the native performance, whereas the red boxes show the performance of this code deployed using Sarus on PeaceDyne. Containerizing a model like Nemo covers all the requirements, meaning that it not only enables the portability and the benefits of deployment, but it also complies with the very strict performance requirements that this code has. For those of you who are interested in more examples like this and also best practices on how to containerize scientific applications and specifically climate and weather models like Nemo, you can find all the information of the container hackathon at this link down here. The information is publicly available for anyone to download. Now, the next project that I would like to talk to you about today is the Human Brain project. In the context of this project, there is an effort called the Neurorobotics Platform, which focuses on studying models of the brain and body through a web browser. It enables real-time experiments connecting several moving pieces, namely the nervous system of a robot, its brain responses, and a fully virtual environment. The interesting aspect of the Neurorobotics platform is its challenging architecture. So as you can see here on the right-hand side, there are several components talking to each other in order to enable the complete functioning of this platform. Now, the important detail here to take home is the following. Every component of the Neurorobotics platform has been fully containerized. And this means the web components, which have been containerized using Docker and deployed on top of the OpenStack platform. And on the simulation backend, all components have also been containerized, but in this case, they have been deployed on PSDynt using SARS for the HPC requirements that they have. The whole architecture has been designed in order to support on-demand instances, meaning that each of their components is deployed in real time when a request arrives from the web client itself. At that point, the web components on the OpenStack dynamically request the HPC resources to PSDynt, meaning that the Docker containers are deployed on top of SARS in order for them to have direct access of the HPC resources of the system, namely NVIDIA P100 GPUs and the high-speed Cray Arias interconnect. The results of that simulation are streamed live through the proxy running on OpenStack towards the web client that the user is running. As a conclusion, what these use cases show to us is that containers are already enhancing several scientific workflows by improving portability, easing their deployments, and still maintaining their strict performance requirements. Also, we have seen that containers are already helping bridging the gaps between HPC and cloud on web environments, meaning that more workflows can benefit from high-performance backends like the HPC systems can provide. And not only that, they are also enhancing the HPC experience, the traditional HPC experience, by adding web frontends and interactive visualizations on top of numerical simulations. We believe that this trend will continue to grow in the future and is already including tools like JupyterLab that CSCS also hosts at the address that I'm showing here on the screen, and also of course including Kubernetes, which is a service that we are providing in the context of the Human Brain Project to the scientific community. With that, I would like to close this lightning talk, thanking you very much for your attention.